Perhaps we all wonder how humans will be able to establish a new settlement away from Earth, and particularly one on Mars. In this video, I delve into one of the highly viable options in order for us to achieve this. Since I was a little child, I've always been fascinated by the idea that we could be able to inhabit a new planet and call it our second home. There is currently growing interest in the goal of sending humans to Mars. Various space agencies have begun to study the numerous problems such a mission would present, and among them is the establishment of habitable spaces for humans who will live on Mars. Anyway, fast forward to the year 2050, and perhaps we have managed to send the first team of humans to this red planet. As soon as they arrive, they will require high-quality buildings in which to live and work. They will have taken certain structures with them from Earth, but this can only be a temporary solution. The first colonizers will then quickly have to find a way to build structures using the planet's own resources. The question is how? In this video, this question gets answered. In order for us to colonize Mars, researchers are developing a new kind of concrete that doesn't require water and is even more than twice as strong. Today, thanks to the work of Lin Wan and colleagues at Northwestern University in the US, we are able to make Martian concrete using materials that are widely available on Mars. And most importantly, this concrete can be made without using water, which, as you know, is already a scarce resource on this red planet. It turns out Mars has tons and tons of sulfur, which constitute as much as 17% of the entire planet. That's why most researchers at the moment think that sulfur is going to be the key to the red planet's big construction boom. But this is not the first time we are trying to make concrete using sulfur. Researchers have tried to make sulfur concrete before, here on Earth. In fact, in the 1970s, material scientists explored the possibility of using sulfur concrete to build bases on the moon. The problem with that was, however, in a vacuum, sulfur doesn't become a liquid. It goes straight from solid to gas, making sulfur concrete impossible to make on planets without an atmosphere. But the atmosphere of Mars is sufficient to make sulfur concrete. So the question is, how shall we make sulfur concrete on Mars? According to current research findings, the basic idea is to heat sulfur to about 240 degrees centigrade so that it becomes liquid. Thereafter, we mix it with the Martian soil, which acts as an aggregate, and then we let it cool. The sulfur solidifies, and as it does so, it binds with it the aggregate, and thus creating concrete, which we are basically calling Martian concrete. However, using sulfur has its fair share of problems too. For a start, as sulfur cools, it solidifies to form a monoclinic sulfur, which then transforms into the more stable rhombic sulfur allotrope at lower temperatures. But again, in the process, it happens to shrink, and this creates cavities and sets up stresses that severely weaken the material. So, an important question at the moment is still whether sulfur concrete can be made strong enough and durable enough to be useful on Mars. Wan and colleagues at Northwestern University further went ahead to make some of this concrete. They used simulated Martian soils consisting mainly of silicon dioxide and aluminium oxide with other components such as iron oxide, titanium dioxide, and so on. They also tested various sizes of particles in this aggregate. The tests were quite straightforward. After mixing the aggregate with the different percentages of molten sulfur and allowed the samples to cool into either blocks or whatever shapes that would be necessary for that testing, they measured the physical properties of the resulting materials, properties such as compressive strength and also other failure mechanisms. They also chemically analyzed the mix and simulated its behavior. It turned out that using an aggregate of smaller particles reduces the formation of voids, which significantly increases the strength of the material. The best mix for producing Martian concrete was found to be 50% sulfur and 50% Martian soil, with maximum aggregate size of 1 mm. And it was found to be a strong concrete, attaining compressive strength in excess of 50 MPa, particularly if it is compressed during curing to reduce the formation of any voids. Remember the voids that are formed when the sulfur shrinks? Yes, if it is compressed during curing, those voids can be reduced. This strength is also partly a result of the chemical bonds that sulfur makes with the Martian soil. By comparison, residential building standards here on Earth require concrete with a compressive strength of about 20 MPa. Wan and colleagues also say that the atmospheric conditions on Mars are suitable for this concrete. Both the atmospheric pressure and temperature range on Mars are adequate for hosting sulfur concrete structures. In addition, Martian concrete will come with several other advantages. 1. Martian concrete can be recycled by heating it so that the sulfur melts, and in this way it can be reused repeatedly. It is also fast setting, relatively easy to handle, and comes in extremely cheap compared to having to ferry materials from Earth to Mars. The other advantage of using Martian concrete over Earth concrete is that on Earth, concrete production is the third biggest contributor of CO2 emissions. This means that any Martian concrete will be almost infinitely reusable without taking the same toll on Mars as it is taking on Earth. So, right now, all we need are a new generation of Martian architects to design buildings made of Martian concrete that will be suitable structures for humans to live and work in on this red planet. As a bonus for this video, NASA recently rewarded a design for a 3D printed ice house as a promising use of Martian water deposits that have been discovered recently. This ice house too is intended to provide safe and radiation-proof habitation for Martian settlers. But of course, the water at Mars will be scarce and will better be suited for sustaining the lives of those settlers. The ice house will rely on the power of water to create a pressurized and habitable shell where human and plant life can thrive. It will feature a hydroponic greenhouse, hollowed out ice rooms to give the illusion of space, and a safe area where astronauts can hang out without their suits. Anyway, with that, you now know that we are at least structurally covered to explore Mars. I hope you liked this video and perhaps it won me your subscription. Please do subscribe and hit the notification bell to get notified of my future videos. I endeavor to post a unique and exciting as well as thought-provoking video in as far as materials are concerned. Thank you.